Good morning, children. How are you? I hope you are fine and you are safe. Okay. And you are eating a healthy food also at your home. Okay. Now, yesterday we have completed till here. What are the different agents of dispersal? Whether that's water, wind, water, animals, or explosion of fruits. Now, let us see all the textual reading from here. Okay. New plants from other parts of plants. Okay. Besides growing from seeds, new plants also grow from certain parts, other parts such as roots, stem and leaves of the parent plant. Okay. So here what they are trying to say, not only from seeds, this plant, new plants can grow from the stem, root and leaves and other also parent plant only. What do you mean by parent plant, children? The plants which bears the fruits, this main plant. Okay, next. Some plants like rose, sugar cane and hibiscus grow from stem cuttings. Potato is a stem that grows underground and has buds called eyes. So even you know, children, few plants are growing by the stem also. Okay, stem cuttings. Like hibiscus, rose and sugar cane. See, you can see here stem cutting of the rose grows into a new plant. I told you in the video also, if you want a red flower and yellow flower, then you have to cut and you have to join them with a tape or something. Okay, then you can find that yellow ones also growing in a same plant, two flowers in a same plant. Same like as hibiscus and even the sugar cane also. You see, the potato is a stem. Here this potato is a stem. Okay. Potato has small buds and eyes which are growing into a new plant. Okay, children. Now, any part of a potato has buds on it and they can grow into a new plant. Onion and ginger are also underground stems from which new plants can grow. Sweet potatoes and carrots are examples of plants whose roots can... Okay, we will see this one. Onion and ginger also. Onion, you know, onion and ginger. Yes, they are also underground stems only. Here you can see the sweet potato. Okay, this is sweet potato. Onion and ginger, they didn't give the pictures. Okay, even they also grow into a new plant with their stems only. Okay, and even the sweet potato also. A new plant can grow from the root of the sweet potato. Are you seeing, able to see this new plant? Yes, this is from the root. This is... root of sweet potato. What are the stems? And stems, children, that is above the ground stem, that is hibiscus, rose and sugar cane. Underground stem like potato, onion and ginger. What about the roots which are growing from the new plants? That is sweet potato. Okay, here. Sweet potatoes and carrots are examples of plants whose roots can grow into new plants. The leaves of plants like bryophyllum can grow into new plants. Are you able to see this bryophyllum leaf? Yeah, at the apex they are different cuttings. Okay, from that apex you can find new plants are growing from the leaf, you know. Maybe you have seen. Okay, I have seen. Yes, now coming to the checkpoint. Circle the correct answers. Seeds of gram, pea, maize are monocot seeds. I told you, Nana, like monocot has single grain. Okay. But dicots are two cotyledons. They have two seed leaves. Okay. So, seeds of maize are monocot. Whereas, gram and pea are dicots. Okay. The development of a seed into a seedling is called as what? Germination? No. Budding? No. This is dispersal. Sorry. This is germination. So that is called as germination. The development of a seed into a seedling is called germination. If in your exam they are asking about that, what is germination, then you have to write the development of a seed into a seedling is called germination. Okay. Seeds of cotton are dispersed by what? Water, wind or explosion? Yes, that is wind. And what are the examples, children? Dandelion, hiptage, madar. These are all dispersed by the wind seeds. Okay. Some plants like rose grow from root, leaf or stem cuttings. Yes, that is stem cuttings. Now only we have learned na rose, which one? Rose, hibiscus, sugar cane, that is stem cuttings. Okay. Now next topic is crops and vegetables. When a plant is grown in large quantities at a place for food, it is called a crop. Farmers grow different crops in different seasons. Crops like wheat and gram grown from November to April, winter, are called rabi crops. Crops grown from June to October, summer, are called as kharif crops. Rice, maize, jowar and bajra are kharif crops. Vegetables like cabbage, cauliflower, radish, bean and pea grow during winter. Vegetables like brinjal, pumpkin and gourd grow in summer. So by this you have to learn about what are the crops and vegetables growing different seasons. Okay, so I have explained you about the rabi and kharif crops. Okay, here you can see the rabi crops, they are grown from November to April, it is like winter season, and the crops grown from June to October, they are called as kharif crops. Okay. Even the same apply for the vegetables also. Like vegetables like cabbage, cauliflower and radish are growing during the winter. But the brinjal, pumpkin and gourd means like bottle gourd, bitter gourd are there, na, that are growing in the summer. Okay children, I hope you have understand. Okay, here maize, a kharif crop growing into the summer. So this is a maize crop. So do you like? So much you like, na, the corns, yes, and they are very healthy also. Here the wheat, a rabi crop grown in winter. This is summer summer crop and this is winter crop. Okay, see, this wheats are very important. They give us carbohydrate. Without wheat and rice, can we survive? No, na. So that we have to keep in our mind. Okay, different plants not only grow into in different climates and seasons, but also require different kinds of soil. Rice and jute grow in clay soil, which holds plenty of water. So see children, different climates and different season, even the different soil also needed for the different crops or vegetables. Okay, as you can see, the rice, it holds a lot of water in them. Okay, on the other hand, jowar and bajra grown in sandy soil. So jowar and bajra, they are grown into the sandy soil. Most of the sandy soil is found into the northern states like Rajasthan. Okay, and clay soil you can find in the southern India like Bengaluru or Andhra Pradesh. Okay, and grows like cotton grows well into the black soil. Okay, few of the states found the black, here they are nearby the coastal areas. Okay, tea plants need moist soil and grow into the slopes of hilly areas. In the eastern ghats, in the eastern ghats of like Assam is there, Manipur is there, you can Darjeeling is there. Okay, so there you find the tea leaves are grown in high amount and they are almost grown into the hilly areas. So you can understand how much we are getting the tea crops, how much far we are getting, and we are, and it is available also for us. Yes, next, coconut trees grow in the coastal areas. So where the coconut trees, where the coastal areas like Kerala, right? Maize grows well in the dry soil of plants or plains or hills. Okay, so for the maize crop, they are summer crops, so they need not a lot of plenty of water. They don't need. Okay. So they are just growing into the dry soil only. Okay, plains where you can find a little trees. Okay, hills where you can find the little trees. Okay, onion and groundnut need well drained sandy soil. Okay, but what about the onion and groundnut, beta? They are they need the well drained sandy soil. Like sandy soil must be there, and they should be very well drained. Means the water should be going into nearby them so that they can grow. Okay, next, how do farmers grow good and healthy crops? Plants need to be grown on the large scale to feed the entire population of a country. Okay, so see children, we are depending on the plants, and plants has to be grown in a very large yield, and the production is more, so that it can feed the entire population of a country. It's not only about the country, it's like for the whole planet, because whole planet is depending upon the plants. Yes, all the populations, right? Not only the human beings, but even the animals also. Okay, so it is very important to grow the good and healthy crops. Okay, for a good and healthy crop, farmers know about the soil, climate and season for growing it. Okay, farmers has to know about the soil and climate and season, which season and which soil, whether it's clay soil, sandy soil or moist soil, which one, dry soil. Okay, climate, whether it's very hot climate or cold climate. They plough and prepare the soil. They plough with the help of the different machines or like ox and buffalo. They are helping the ploughing. Okay, and they have to prepare the soil. They choose healthy and ripe seeds for sowing. So they have to take the healthy and ripe seeds. See, few seeds are not that much nutritious and they can't grow into a new plants. Okay, so the farmers has to take the healthy crops only, healthy seeds, so that we can grow a new plant which are very healthy. Okay, they add manure or fertilizers to the soil. Manure is added to the soil to increase production. Why we are adding manure, beta? We are adding the manure to increase the production in high amount. Okay, in high amount, to yield the product in high amounts. Okay, fertilizers like urea, super phosphate, ammonium sulfate and nitrate are also added to the soil. So these are the different types of different types of fertilizers like urea. Okay, I told you about the DDT and BHC also, right? Super phosphate is one of the, this is most consists of phosphorus. Okay, ammonium sulfate, this is rich in sulfur and ammonia also. Okay, and nitrate, that is nitrate is rich in nitrogen. Okay, however, overuse of chemical can be harmful to the soil as well as the crop. Yes, I told you already, like anything in the excess is very very danger. Okay, even the manure is added to the soil. So why these fertilizers are using, these fertilizer are using to remove the pests and the insecticides. Okay, and why the manure is using to increase the production. Okay, they irrigate the soil, means giving the water, take caring of all the crops. Yes, that is called as irrigation. Okay, from the rivers, from the wells and from the resources of water, the farmers are taking the water and they are irrigating the soil. That process is called as irrigation. Okay, protection of crops and storage of seeds. Farmers protect the crops against, see, even the now if we are now the here the good and healthy crops we have grown. Now what is the next thing? That is protection of crops and storage of crops. Okay, so that is also very important, children. If protection is not done, and then can we have that grains and seeds and whatever we are eating? No. And if the storage is not possible in the market, it will come from the farmers to the to the ordinary people? No. So that's the reason production and storage of seeds are also very important. Farmers protect the crops against, what are the things that farmers protecting our crops? Okay, grazing animals like cows and goats. This is done by proper fencing. See, most of the goats and cows and goats, if they finding any of the fields or crops, they try to come into that fields and they start grazing. And what happen again? Our production and our crops are eaten by the goats and cows. So can we eat that type of that type of crops? No, we can't. So that is done by the proper fencing. If the farmers have done the proper fencing so that the goats and cows will be away, then it will be good. It means we are protecting. Okay, next. Pests such as locusts, grasshoppers and caterpillars. They use pesticides. These are the chemicals that are sprayed on standing crops. If sprayed properly, they protect the crops from being destroyed by pests. However, too much pesticides can be harmful to our health. Okay, and last one is diseases. See here, pests like insects like locust, grasshopper, and caterpillars. They find on the leaves or leaves and other parts of the plant, and they are just eating them because they have to survive, right? They are eating them. So if we have to protect from them, then we have to spray it on the standing crops. So what are these? Those are the fertilizers which are spraying. Okay, so when we are spraying them, we are protecting our crops. Okay, children. Now, and they have to protect from the diseases also. If the farmers are using the good kind of crops, then it very least it is possible that they are free from diseases. Okay. When the grains are ripe, the crops are harvested and stored. After harvesting, grains need to be protected against moisture. They have to be kept safe from rats, moles, birds, squirrels, and insects. So they must be stored in airtight sealed containers. Okay, this we have already read. Like when the grains are ripened, and they have to be stored in a very airtight containers so that they can be protected from the rats, moles, squirrels, and in other insects. Okay, when as soon as the rats enter into the storage of crops, they can destroy everything, beta, and then we can't consume that crops again. So that is the reason we have to protect them against all the things. So what we can do, we have to store in a airtight containers. Okay, after harvesting only we have to do this all. Okay, now plants like other living things need love and care. Under favorable condition they grow well. A good crop adds the wealth of a country. See, now we are totally depend upon the plants, and if the crops are good, if the plants are good, then that if we are eating them, then we are also healthy, and it our immunity will be more. Okay, so but when we are take caring of the plants, even they also need the love and care. Okay, it's not like that we have to destroy them or we have to cut them. No, we have to love and care means we have to be fine then in a we have to pour the water every day. We have to check every day whether any pest is eating that leaves or other parts of the plant or crops that we have to take care. Yes, we have to store them. Yes, these are all the things when we have to do them. So children, this is the end of our chapter. Tomorrow we will start this textual exercises we will do. Okay. Okay, before going to this chapter, what are the things we have done? Just going to once again, beta. Here, what are the things, what are the plants gives us? Okay, about the seed germination, new plants from the seeds, and then here it is the seeds and its parts. Then we have done experiments, and then what is the process of germination? Okay, then dispersal of the seeds, and what are the agents of dispersal? Yesterday we have seen, and then today what we have seen, children, and what are the examples for all the dispersal? And here the new plants and other plants like what you call as, this is called as vegetative propagation. What is it called, children? It is vegetative propagation. Okay, now and next is crops and vegetables. How we have to store, how that we have to, how the farmers has to grow, what are the things, which crops, vegetables are growing which season, okay, which months also. Okay, next about the healthy crops also. Okay children, I hope you have understand so many things in this chapter. It's a very lengthy chapter and you liked it very in with your heart. Okay children, take care, bye bye.